about travel and motherhood. In today's video, I wanted to share with you guys some travel hacks that I've learned through the years on how to plan the perfect road trip. When you're planning to go on an epic road trip, the first thing that you have to figure out is, where are you trying to go? Let's say, for example, you want to explore the Pacific Northwest, and let's say that you know you want to go to Portland, you want to go to Seattle, but you also want to go to Olympic National Park, which I totally recommend, by the way. Now, what I will do is I will go into Google Maps and I will open up the Pacific Northwest, see where each of these cities or destinations are and how close they are to each other, and think of the best way to combine visiting all these places on one road trip. Now, of course, you're gonna wanna combine these in a way that makes the most sense if you're on a budget, and also to be able to see everything you wanna see and maybe even some little spots along the way. Now, once you've figured out where you wanna go, you're gonna wanna figure out, will you be taking a round trip or will you be starting in one city and ending in another city? Some factors that play into this are you flying to your starting destination, or do you live close enough that you can just start from home? Now, in my experience, usually it is cheaper to fly in and out of the same city, as well as return a rental car, for example, to the same place that you got it from. Now, while this is usually true, it's not always the case, and it definitely is worth your while to budget out all the different scenarios. Let's go back to our example. Is it cheaper to fly into Portland from where you live, or is it cheaper to fly into Seattle? Or maybe there's some obscure smaller airport that it's cheaper to fly into. Now, once you've decided on where you're going and how you're gonna get there, now we need to figure out what's gonna be your means of transportation. Are you gonna rent a car? Or are you gonna take an RV? Now, if you've been around for a while, you probably know that we love ourselves a good RV vacation, just because for us, traveling with a toddler, it just makes more sense to have all of our belongings in one spot and not have to change where we're sleeping and pack and unpack every night. Now, let's say you're a little bit more flexible and you wanna take a car. Some obvious advantages of a car are, when you're going into big cities and you're thinking about things like parking, a car is definitely the better option. But let's say you're looking to explore a national park and you're gonna be doing hiking and things like that. It doesn't really matter whether you're in an RV or in a car. So you just kind of need to decide what's better for your family. Now, once we've decided on our means of transportation, we're gonna go back to the route planning. And planning the exact route depends on a couple of factors. How many days do you have? Are you starting and stopping at the same spot, or are you just going from point A to point B? And then, of course, we also want to factor in, are we trying to take the scenic route where we see as much as we can on the way, or are we just trying to get from point A to point B as fast as possible? And again, this all depends on how many days you have, what you're trying to achieve, where you're going, how many people you have with you, do you have kids with you, and so on and so forth. And now that we have our route picked out, it's time to figure out lodging. And regardless of whether you're camping or if you're staying in a hotel, you need to decide how far you can enjoyably drive each day. Let's say you have 7 days for a road trip and you're trying to drive over 1,000 miles. Chances are, you know, there are gonna be some days that you really need to hustle and you need to drive for long periods of time, and then there's other days where maybe you can take it a little bit more easy. But you decide all of this when you're picking your route. So if I'm looking at a map and I know that I want to get from, let's say, Portland to Cannon Beach to Olympic National Park. Now, Cannon Beach is only an hour and a half drive from Portland, but Olympic National Park is quite a bit further. But I want to spend the night somewhere where maybe I can do an activity first thing the next morning, or if there's a good spot to eat breakfast. So these are all things that I like to take into consideration when I am planning where to spend the night. And here's the deal. If I can stay outside of the big city, I will, because chances are it's gonna be cheaper, it's not gonna be as busy. And while you may not have as many options, a lot of times we've found some really cool camp spots or hostels that are outside of the bigger cities. And finally, my favorite part of planning a trip, the food. Just kidding. Of course, the sightseeing. You're going to want to pick your must-see destinations and your lodging accordingly. Let's say there are some places that you want to go that are super touristy. So you might want to hit those up either first thing in the morning or later in the day when they're about to close. And then pick where you're spending the night accordingly. If you're going to a super touristy destination, you want to go first thing in the morning, well, try to find a spot to sleep that's relatively close to there so you can get up early in the morning and just go straight there and not have to drive a far distance to get there. But back to the food. I was only half kidding because we definitely plan our road trips around certain places that we have to eat. And I have definitely been known to plan an overnight stay according to a breakfast spot that I really, really wanted to go to. So to sum all of that up, there's a couple of different ways that you can plan your lodging and plan your route, you know, based on places that you have to see and places that you really want to eat at. But you know what? Last but not least, my biggest tip of this whole thing is just to stay flexible. Because sometimes the best places are places that nobody told you about or places you weren't expecting. So I definitely would advise that you leave some wiggle room in your plans. You don't want to jam everything so full that, let's say you see this gorgeous spot on the Pacific Coast Highway that you've never heard of and you have to stop there, but you only have 10 minutes because you've got your day so planned out that you can't stop. So I really like to leave about a day of wiggle room in my plans in case, you know, some spot pops up that I just would love to stay at longer or visiting a spot that I wasn't anticipating. That's really my number one tip for planning the perfect road trip. Stay flexible. And once you have your route picked out, I know we all have smartphones and we all have tablets and GPSs, but I'm kind of old school in that I like to print out pages of my maps of what I was planning to drive each day, because we've definitely been in situations where all of a sudden there is no internet, or let's say, God forbid, your phone dies and you have no idea where you're going. It's always good to have some kind of a map handy so you don't get stranded. So thanks for watching, guys. I really hope you guys learned some good tips in this video. Please leave a comment below on your most epic road trip and where you went, and I'll leave a comment of mine as well. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up because it really supports my channel. And if you haven't yet, please subscribe. Come on, what you waiting for? Thanks, guys. Talk to you again soon. Bye.